Good afternoon, students of the University of Ghana. My name is Mame Sewa Akofola-Wotri, and I'm your SRC Secretary. Today I am at CCC, the Careers and Counseling Center. It is a very important center that is being run by the university for students. You know, students can come here for a lot of resources to come for counseling concerning their career, their relationships, and any other thing that you want to talk about that you're having issues with. But a lot of students still do not make their way here because of the lack of information and the lack of knowledge on what actually happens here. So today I'm here with Lady Edwina Pencil, who is the placement coordinator for the Counseling Placement Center, and she's going to tell us a lot about this place. So, Madam or Lady Edwina, good afternoon. Okay, so please, we would like you to tell us a bit about the Careers and Counseling Center. So that's why we are here today.
So the Careers and Counseling Center is a place for students and staff of the University of Ghana. Our main aim is to help students formulate their goals in life. So we have various sectors. As the name says, it's a career center and it's also a counseling center. So the counseling center, we have career counselors, we have counselors, we have psychometricians, we have psychologists, we have clinical psychologists, we have psychiatrists who always come here to help students and also the staff.
Before you move, you know, to detail whatever you said, please, what is the psychometrics?
Okay, so the psychometrician is someone who is supposed, usually the person runs tests. So we have some tests that could check your personality type, your career type, and all these type of tests. So we just have someone who is a resident psychometrician. She's always here to help students if they need help in any of these fields.
So I'll move on, and you tell us bit by bit what happens, what are the different departments here, and what are the different services that students can access from the CCC.
Okay, so at CCC, Careers and Counseling Center, for the career part, we organize a lot of programs for students that will benefit students. So we have a program called the Professional 360. So the Professional 360 is made up of the Career Development and then the Leadership Academy class. It's a 10-week class, and the students are supposed to register when they start school. So it's run every semester. So at the beginning of the semester, you come to the department, the center, to register your name. And then you start to choose whether we have different classes. We have the Monday class and we have the Friday class. You choose which one is more convenient for you. And then for the leadership, we have only a Wednesday class. So for the career development, what we do is that we take students on how to get a career, how to get a job. So we teach topics like job trends, how to write a good CV, how to attend an interview, and at the end of the whole session, with the 10 weeks, we have a mock interview. So for the mock interview, usually we get people from various industries to come and sit on the panel to talk to interview students. So it's a mock interview, but it's also they just get an experience of how an interview is supposed to go to when they go for an interview in future. Then after that, then they take the Leadership Academy class the next semester. So for the Leadership Academy class, we assume that you've gone to the Career Development class and you can now get a job. But we need you to also sustain that job. So that's how come we come with the Leadership class. So the Leadership class, we teach you presentation skills, we teach you time management, we teach you communication skills and a whole lot of things that will help you sustain the job when you get a job. So that's for the Professional 360. And then after the Professional 360, we have something called Career Week. And then Career Week is done every semester, every year, every academic year for students. It's usually done during February or March. So this year, our Career Week is going to start on 27th February to 2nd March. So for Career Week, we get companies from various industries, a lot of companies to come here. So we get them to bring their HR managers and HR staff to the university to employ students. So most of them come here, we set up a stand for them, and they are supposed to meet students one-on-one, because we all know it's difficult sending your CVs to companies and you're not allowed to meet the HR managers or allowed to even meet the right person for an internship or something. So we bring these people here to come and set up a stand, and then the students are supposed to bring their CVs, have an interaction with these companies, and then they always get internships, national service placements, part-time jobs, and then we open it up to alumni, because some of these companies come and give full employment to some of our alumni. So these are some of the things that go on during Career Week.
So that's about the Career Week. And then after the Career Week, we also have something called Mentoring Day. So for this one, we open it up to staff of the university, and we also open it up to outsiders who want to mentor students. So the students who are looking out for someone who to guide them, sign up their details, write their details for us, and then we pair them with someone in the industry, or we pair them with a lecturer who will mentor them for the whole academic year. Then after that, we rotate, we change it, or we give someone else to another person based on the comments and the results or reports we get. So that's for the mentoring. And then we also have something called Dare to Start Entrepreneurship Program. So for the Dare to Start Entrepreneurship Program, it was students who have business ideas, students who have something they want to come up with. So then they go through a challenge where they are taught how to write a business proposal, how to write a business canvas, and all those things, and how to pitch their business to get funding, some funding. And then we also get people from various industries to come in, also those who can fund such student projects, we get them to also come, and then the students pitch it out to the industries, and then the sponsor, and then if your pitch is good, you can win something. So usually, since it's also a challenge, we have the first person, we have the second, and we have the third. So the first person gets some amount of money to start up the business, the second does the same, and then the third also does the same. So that's for the Dare to Start program. Then after the Dare to Start program, we also have something called the Educational Fair. This is also run every year. So for the Educational Fair, we have people from different universities, especially those outside, come here to talk to students about getting postgraduate, masters or PhD in their universities. So they come here to show students on how to apply for their university, and also how to get scholarships into their universities. So that's what the Educational Fair is.
This happened usually in the first semester, right? Because I remember the one we just had, I was there. So usually what month is this?
Usually done in October, so at the first semester. So we actually run a lot of programs at the center. And then we also have something called Transform My Community. So that one is done at, it's organized every long vacation. So students also apply for this one. They go through a little interview so that we select the right people. And then usually we are looking out for people, students who have some entrepreneurship idea, because they'll be taken to a rural community to go and stay there for some weeks. Usually it's just 2 weeks or 3 weeks. And then they are supposed to live with the people in the community. So they are given host families to live with.
and then they are supposed to come up with an idea or something that the community is looking out for. So if they go to a community that's really deprived and they see that they have maybe a lot of cassava, and then they can find a way to transform the cassava into something else, the students are supposed to pick up such things and find ways and solutions to help this community. So that's what the transform mic.
So this is just like probably a volunteer staff to help the community. Okay, which volunteering is also very important, especially when you want to do masters and stuff. You know, your ability to show what you have volunteered, or you know, giving time for volunteership is also part of some of the requirements sometimes, and it helps you. So that's what you people are trying to promote with this program. Okay, so
we want to promote people students to volunteer, and students to also go into more setting up their own thing. So at least this will guide them in
using, you know, one stone to kill two birds.
Okay. Definitely. So that's what Transform My Community is about. And then also we have